Hello everybody, once again, this is Aqua Kazu and welcome back to another Community League PvP Season 1 Week 1. Now we are in Westwood, we have Parokian and Jab up against TGIF. Oh, thank god it's Friday, just kidding guys. But in Paro, we have I, Meninus as the captain, is a gladiator, Ray Hanapi, a Elestra, Sini Sin, a shooting star, J Marin 18, a guardian, and Minfrape, a tempest. And in TGIF, we have Praised, a physician. I think this is the first physician I'm seeing. We have Plasmodium. I believe that is actually a Windwalker. We have Ashes 92, Elestra, Kedadry Frog, a Crusader, and finally Scarface, a Moonlord. And let's get to the match right away. So right now we're into the match between Paro, I'm going to call him Paro or Paro for short, and up against TGIF. Oh, thank god it's Friday. And indeed it is not Friday, today is actually Tuesday, I believe. As it's 6 a.m. right now as I'm doing this, the fourth match that I've recorded so far, we have Scarface and Moonlord going up against the Guardian here. As I believe the Guardian is J Mayren 18, or is it 17? Can't really remember his number here. Electric Smite here on Scarface is good at the start, and even the Lightning Zap as well into the Holy Relic, but that's avoided by Scarface here. The Harpoon Slash, oh, 7.5k damage on J Mayren here. So it's actually 18, I see his number right now. As you can see him buffing up with his Iron Wheel and he heals up back to 90% HP. He's doing well from the start here. The Moonblade Dance there, that was about 3 ticks on J Mayren. He's still extremely healthy at about 88% HP. But Scarface here is down to 86%. He gets hit by a Holy Bolt here. But it's Crescent Cleave. Oh, that's such a troll, Crescent Cleave here. He actually flinched J Mayren there, preventing him from advancing towards Scarface. But a nice armor break into Electric Smite here. As you can see, Scarface taking huge damage here. 50%, 26% HP after the Justice Crash here from J Mayren. J Mayren definitely doing very well here. And a nice Shinbreaker there on the Death Slash. Oh, we can see the Secret Hammering buff doing huge damage here. 10% HP left for Scarface here as he avoids the Holy Relic. Once again, a Half Moon Slash into Grave here, but J Mayren uses his Aerial Vision well and timely here. And Scarface getting hit by the Divine Avatar of 0% HP left. The Shield Charge definitely takes him away. No, the Shield Charge doesn't, but he gets killed by a few normal attacks in the first round as J Mayren grabs one win for, I believe, to be, I think it's TGIF. Did I get it right? I can't actually remember whether red team is Paro. I think red team is Paro and TGIF is in the blue team. Hopefully I didn't get it wrong. Let me check the names right now. Indeed it is. Paro is actually, no, it's the other way. Paro is actually for J Mayren and TGIF is for previously Scarface. So right now, Praised is from TGIF. My mistake here. You can see the Injector EX here. That is definitely a physician trademark. And we see the next infection here. Oh, a nice Holy Bolt once again from J Mayren from Paro. The Justice Crash avoided by a nice air drop and even the Magma Wave on Electric Smite counter here. Very well done by Prayers into Hypnosis here, as right now J Mayren's in trouble, down to 55% HP. The Bubble just barely dodged there by J Mayren as Praised is actually pushing her advantage here. Injected EX here as she goes in. Magma Tower as well to trap J Mayren at the moment, but the Divine Vata is not quite used yet. Oh, the Mixed Infection actually hits J Mayren here into a Poison Break. You can see J Mayren now down to about 30% HP here as Praised goes in strong. The Holy Bolt once again very accurate from J Mayren, but a nice dodge from Praised that prevents the damage from breaking up on the Electric Smite here. Once again, Magma Wave hitting on the target. I believe the Ice Shower is coming out. Indeed, the Ice Shower is out. But a lucky block into Divine Vata here. Unlucky for Praised definitely, but lucky for J Mayren. As you can see, he's slowed down to a snail as J Mayren will not be able to chase Praised. But a nice healing shower there for Praised as a physician here. She heals back up to about 81% HP right now. The airdrop once again used very well by Praised. As right now, J Mayren is backing out here to buy time for heals once again. A bubble barely missing J Mayren once again. Praised goes in with a nice magma wave once again. J Mayren backs out, 12% HP left now for this guy. Back to 25% after the heal. The Magma Wave used Defense Leaf Injector into Hypnosis once again. Brilliant Hypnosis from Praised once again. As you see the small punches from the Magma Punch and Icy Punch here. No longer the EX version, as this is not Adept. This is a Physician for you guys once again. As you see the Love Virus not finding the target this time. 52% HP left for Praised here. As she avoids the Holy Bolt this time. The bubble chasing once again. She avoids the Shinbreaker entrance from... Oh, the Magma Wave takes J Mayren away after she avoids the Electric Smite and Justice Crash combo. So Praised, definitely a decent physician here as she wins this round against J Mayren. We have quite a healthy amount of HP left. That's about 62% HP left, I believe. As we see who Peril will be setting up next, as Priest definitely did well for TJF here. As we see Minfrape coming up next, and Minfrape will be a Tempest here. As you see, and you know that the first 10 to 15 seconds is extremely important against Academic class here. The Wax is used defensively here. The Processing Break hitting for 9.8k. As you can see, Minfrape here down to 74% HP. As she doesn't seem to be doing well, let's start from the round. The Love Virus enters here, but the Ice Pump here landing into the Magma Wave. She's down to 45% HP now, 47% HP in fact. Nice Magma Wave or Magma Tower used defensively here, as we see Minfrape down to 32% HP. As you can see, a nice heal from Priest here on a Healing Shower. She's back to 64% HP here. But the mana counter is not very good. We haven't seen a Hypnosis being used yet from Priest. Hopefully we see a nice Hypnosis here once again. Love Virus, oh, Love Virus actually hit into Ice Shovel catching here of Minfrape. As you can see, once again, Priest, very well done. This physician definitely deserves a thumbs up from everyone watching her right now. As she's fighting for Team, thank God it's Friday. So be wondering what Peril will be setting up next. I think it's going to be the Gladiator. Indeed it is, it's the Captain. I'm melee lost. It's coming up, the Gladiator. Once again, he's going up fast. He hits by the first stun grenade and an icy grenade as well. He's slowed down right now. Not good moments for Iron Melanus here. As you can see, good dodging skills from Priest here. Even the Magma Wave catching. Magma Tower used defensively, but look at that. Menelaus actually avoided for nice. The Hypnosis dodge as well. Well done by Iron Menelaus here. Into finish attack here. But once again, a nice airdrop from Priest here. Dodge. Ice Bomb is out, used defensively as well. A bubble bubble on the parrying stance once again, and a nice heal from Priest once again into a stunning grenade here. As I see the poison break coming very soon, definitely. Injector EX being used, ice shovel used once again, as right now Iron Menelaus is in trouble here. But look at that, Priest is down 21% HP, and the Magma Wave taking away. Oh, look at that, the front shift iframe was used, but it was not good enough. It wasn't long enough for the Magma Wave. It was not good enough for the unrelentless attack from Priest here, as she gets into a 3 winning streak as a physician here. Something you definitely don't see every day from a physician class, simply because physicians are actually very rare as well. But right now, how will Peril actually answer? They send out Sini Sin, which I believe is a shooting star. Yes, indeed, it's a shooting star here. So right now, it's up to Priest to actually go in fast, because aside from the Icicle Expression counter here, she cannot wait for Sini Sin to actually set up here. Indeed, she does well. The poison break hits very start, but she gets hit by a flash grenade here into a gravity grenade. Oh, nice flash from Sini Sin here to take away Priest from TGIF. So Sini Sin does well with the flash grenade timing there. Pity for Priest. I was actually hoping that she can take away another player here, but the HP counter for Priest is definitely too low here. As we will see, who will TGIF send up next? I believe it's going to be Elestra. That's my guess. No, they send out the Windwalker Plasmodium. See the buffs going up right now. As right now, you're letting the shooting star set up. Oh, the 10 to 15 seconds will be gone very, very soon. But it's a shooting star, it's not a gear master here, so there isn't a Mecha Duck iframe here. But it seems like Plasmodium has just dashed to a death here. Oh, look at that, Ping Pong EX hitting as well, down to 50% HP here. As the splash goes in as well, she's silenced at the moment with the Gravity Grenade. Continue combo. Oh, Biochemical Missile here, down to 25% HP. Even the Stun Grenade as well. Sini Sin doing very well. The Rising Storm used to fight against the Ducks, but she got killed by the Ice Pump Tower Rain that was landing on her while she was charging up her Rising Storm. So right now, Sini Sin, as the Academic Class 4 Peril, is doing her own winning streak of 2 winning streaks. As right now, both Academic Classes here from both teams are doing very well. One is a Physician and one is a Shooting Star. Both not really the common matchups that we will see. But right now, Ashes 92, the Elestra, is going up against Sini Sin. And definitely, the Academic is in a disadvantageous position here because of the Super Armor boost here. And no iframe from Mecha Duck as well. You can see that Ashes knows that she cannot let Sini Sin stand up. But she gets caught. Oh, looks like she needs to use Slash Escape here as she's bugged out. As we're gonna PM. Indeed, she uses Slash Escape immediately. She avoids the bubble there barely. Nice catching with the Freezing Sword EX, but the Ice Sphere not used as well. But look at that, the Chilling Mist getting Sini Sin. But she tries to roll away from the Ice Sphere. The nice Rocket Jump prevents Sini Sin from getting hit by the Shatter here. But I believe Ashes 92 actually got silenced by the Mecha Duck there. She backs up. Freezing Sword is avoided as well, but Sini Sin 6% HP left. I don't think that's going to be enough here. Alfredo transitional damage is used, but 6% HP is definitely not enough. Oh, look at that, the bubble bubble actually caught Ashes 92 here, aims to the gravity grenade, and my goodness, look at that, Alfredo beam into Skyline as well, huge damage for Sinistin. Ashes goes into a 3 winning streak, my goodness, what a turnaround of events here, a comeback for Sinistin with the nice bubble bubble, and we saw the Alfredo beam used in a PvP fashion here. That was the full damage of Alfredo beam on Ashes 92, something that's very unexpected. Definitely a nice comeback for Sinistin here, as both academic classes we have praised previously as a physician, and now we have Sinistin as a shooting star. But Sinistin with now 16% HP left going up against Kadri Frog, which is a crusader. We're gonna see the Judgment Hammer coming. Indeed, the Judge Hammer is used, and the Holy Relic as well. Oh, look at that, the Judge Hammer actually baited the tumble there, and then a nice Holy Relic continuation from Kadri Frog takes Sinistin away. So right now I believe they are both down to the last team members here, as we goes into a 1-1 fight. So Kadri Frog, the Crusader, go well up against, I believe the last member is the Elestra Ray Hanapi here. So the Frostwind from the start is definitely important here. We'll see if Ray can actually do that. The Frostwind is avoided here. Fizzing Sword, that's 2, takes 6,000 damage, and a nice Flame Spunk there, and the Poison Spray as well. Nicely done. So a Glacier Wave once again, but she just used the Freezing Wall instead. Holy Bolt there, into Lightning Zap here, not too good for Rui at the moment, but she avoids the Electric Smite here. Nicely done, nicely dodged as well, as she caught Kadri right now. Right now Frog is down to about 35% HP, 9 Flame Spark flinch as well, as I believe there's a bit of lag here, as you don't quite see the skill that was cast by Rei at the moment. The heal is used from Frog. Once again, he's back to 52% HP. The Sacred Hammering is used as well. Nice Holy Bolt once again, but he backs out here. Oh, the Holy Relic, yes, it's avoided. Electric Smite, oh, couldn't quite bait after the blink as well. So Rei definitely did well to dodge that Electric Smite there. It's right now Frog is in trouble here, gets caught by the Frostwind. The Divine Avatar is forced, but you can see that Rei is also down and very low on mana. She's down to 25% mana here, and she offs the Ice Shield here to save her mana, and Flame Roads away from the Divine Avatar here. Definitely wise to do so. Avoids the Holy Relic as well, gets her Ice Shield back up, as we wonder whether Rei will actually grab the round for Peril. Indeed she does, with the Ice Spear in the Chilling Mist combo on the Stance of Faith. Well, decision making once again from Peril here. The Elestra Ray Hanapi here on the Ice Sphere, on the Stance of Faith here. So maybe that was not quite good for Frog himself. But right now we're into game 2 with Scarface going up against Min Frape here, the Tempest. The Moonblade does not quite finding a target on Min Frape. We see the Crescent Cleave once again, but this time it's only one wave of the Crescent Cleave, as it was cancelled halfway. The Half Moon Slash is baited as well, as Min Frape goes in, but lucky parry there for Scarface prevents him from getting comboed. The Hurricane Dance avoided as well by Scarface, as Min Frape has the Spirit Boost buff. Oh, look at that Moonblade Dance, one tick on the Tempest here, which is Min Frape. Scarface still doing quite well, 90% HP here. How about Min Frape here? I think Min Frape has around the same amount of HP. Yup, indeed she has around the same amount of HP. She goes in with a nice spiral iframe here, but got caught by a parry once again to counter wave. The Eclipse here from Scarface is well used as well. More ticks of the Moonblade Dance as well, but they're just treating each other at the moment here, as Scarface gets hit by the ultimate from the Tempest. The Grey Wave catching as well, but Hurricane Dance, my goodness, not quite there for Scarface once again, as he uses the little super armor of Grey Wave there to get out of the Hurricane Dance. But the Spiral Vortex max damage here on the Flash Dance here. I don't think Flash Dance is a well decision used for Scarface when he was such close. I mean, he was so close to Min Frape, but Min Frape got hit by the Half Moon Slash as well. Kick shot into Circle Shot, as Scarface is down 22% HP. The Eclipse once again is extremely close between these two players at the moment here. Kick shot into Spiral Vortex, not quite finding the target once again, as the Moonblade Dance takes Min Frape away. Nicely done by Scarface here as a Moon Lord, as Min Frape backs up but got hit by the Moonblade Dance as she ran out of tumbling and mobility skills as a Tempest. So we'll see what Peril is going to be sending next. So TGIF, Scarface grabs one for TGIF, as right now we see I Manilaus, the Gladiator. So it's a Gladiator up against a Moon Lord matchup here, a seemingly mirror matchup once again. As you see, Moonlight Splitter EX up against Moonlight Splitter, but both not finding the target. That was pretty amusing to see. Moonblade Dance entirely dodged by Many Laos once again, nicely done. Eclipse cancelling of the Cyclone Slash. As I believe we see some lag here, but right now, Scarface is in trouble. Even his counter exile is used, he's out of air evasion options at the moment. But Many Laos got hit by a Half Moon Slash, his own Half Moon Slash hitting Scarface here. I think that was unexpected here. Scarface didn't know that a Gladiator actually had a Hybrid Brute here. So Many Laos is a Hybrid Brute Gladiator for PvP here. As he killed Scarface with a Half Moon Slash. So a Moonlord getting killed by a Half Moon Slash from a Gladiator, that's another amusing fact to know in this matchup. So we are wondering right now what TGIF is going to be sending out. So we see Plasmodium, the Windwalker, is going up against I Many Laos, the Gladiator here. Binding Shot used. She goes into Spiral EX here. Nice Cyclone Kick iframe being used, but cancelled by a nice skills. Vision of I Many Laos, cancelling the Spiral Vortex as well. As the Circle Shot is baited as well, as now Plasmodium is down to about 25%. She avoids the Half Moon Slash and the Rising Storm, cancelled by a nice Finch Attack anticipation here by I Many Laos. Hacking Stance is used as well for mobility. Nice multi shot to cancel, but you can see I Many Laos not giving up here. But the Spirit Boost is used from Plasmodium. I think we're going to be seeing another Rising Storm very soon. Showtime is used as well. Spiral Vortex used, not quite there once again from Plasmodium. Circle Shot baited for I Many Laos against Plasmodium. Nicely done. The ultimate avoided because he was out of range. Oh, he got caught in the Rising Storm, not too well for I Many Laos here as he's down to 1% HP. He backs out his own Great Wave, is avoided with a nice tumble as the Circle Shot takes him away. What a turnaround of events here with Plasmodium catching him with a nice Rising Storm here. You can see how much damage that Rising Storm do if you get caught here. I think I Many Laos at about 60% HP, but that was gone in an instant when he got caught in the Rising Storm. But as a Windwalker, if your own gameplay, I mean if your only gameplay is using Rising Storm, I don't think that's enough here. You must never forget your roots as an acrobat and do basic combos as a Windwalker, definitely. As right now we see the Shooting Star, I believe, going against the Windwalker here. So right now we have Sinisin going up against Plasmodium here, the Shooting Star that did very well earlier on, doing a, I think 3 winning streak here. So will he be able to do the same? Plasmodium is down to 55% HP here. You should never let a Shooting Star or Game Master set up, but right now the Fortress of the Shooting Star is set up here. The Wax is used defensively once again, once you see that the opponent is going, once again Rising Storm used, but getting hit by the Ice Pump Tower instead. The Spirit Boost effect is wearing off here, it'll be harder for Plasmodium to answer once the Spirit Boost is up. The Spiral Vortex once again not finding a target for Plasmodium. Showtime is used once again, but Sinisin still at 100% HP, doing very well here. Flash Grenade here, not quite used at the right time. Avoids the ultimate as well from the Windwalker. As we can see, Alfredo transitional damage here, so if Sinisin gets caught here, he'll be fine. The Rising Storm used once again. Get hit by the Ice Pump Tower, he's slowed down at the moment. Oh, get hit by Splash as well, 45% HP right now as Sinisin chases. The Wax is used. As Plasmodium gets out, he's down to 34% HP. He's running away from all the monsters that's chasing around him now. We see two Darks, one Alfredo, and two Towers. The shooting, the Ping Pong EX is avoided barely there. As the Gravity Grenade is used defensively once again. Icy Pump Tower is out once again. It's not a good time to enter right now. Once again, a very nice Bubble Bubble from Sinisin into a Biochemical Missile here. Definitely very well done from Sinisin here with a brilliant long range Bubble Bubble after the tumble there. That was anticipating Bubble Bubble from Sinisin. I think Plasmodium is in disbelief as well. He was like, what? That was definitely very awesome from Sinisin. As I say my what again, which I used in Belfry's video when he used Hacking Stunt here. That was a disbelief moment for me as well. In the anticipating Bubble Bubble long range deals, as we see Category from the Crusader up against Sinisin as well. As right now, Peril seems to be in good shape. As they are right now 1-0 up against TGIF in the previous round where Frog couldn't quite match up against Elestra, which is very handy. But right now, look at that, nice Bubble Bubble from Sinisin once again with the Gravity Grenade. Oh, look at that, the splash damage here, that was like, I don't know, 2k times 4? About 10,000 damage there, definitely. As you can see, Frog right now down to about 35% HP, using all his skills defensively right now, on the darts, on the monsters that's chasing him, on the fortress that's unleashed upon him right now. Nice Electric Smart iframe use on Sinisin right now, as Sinisin is down 25% HP. As you can see him healing up as well. So will Sinisin be able to take Frog away, the Crusader? Even the Judge Hammer used against the wall, no idea what happened there here. The Bubble Bubble this time not quite finding the target. Gravity Grenade used defensively. As I believe Frog will be waiting for the Divine Avatar moment here. Holy Relic there is avoided. I believe, I'm not too sure what happened there. The Divine Vata is used by his load by the Icy Pump Tower here. The Wax is used by Sinisin for mobility as the Alfredo Beam this time. Not quite useful as the Divine Vata prevents him from taking any damage. Nice Judge Hammer there to bait the tumble from Sinisin here into a Shin Breaker here, into the Shield Charge as well. Well done by Frog here to bait the tumble there. And the Holy Relic! Oh, Holy Relic EX takes Sinisin away. Well done by Frog in this one with 47% HP left. As he regains 10% HP left, that means he had 37% HP from Sinisin. I think Sinisin did a pretty good job here to bring Frog down to 47% HP. But is that enough for Peril here? I mean, for TGIF to green back another round from Peril. So right now, Ray, which is the Elestra, which won Frog earlier on, is up. So it seems like, I think Peril wants to end this as soon as possible. She avoids the Holy Relic EX, the Frostwind is used right now. The Crusader is slowed to a halt. Nice Flame Spark here into Freezing Sword EX. But Electric Smite there, I believe that was lag here. As Frog backs out with Block at the moment. He gets caught by a Glacial Wave instead into a Chilling Mist, avoids the Chilling Mist well there. Into Holy Relic EX, but it was actually cancelled by the Freezing Sword because he had Block up. Once again, Stance of Faith on Ice Spear this time. He's frozen once again. He's caught in poison right now. Into the freezing wall here. He's trapped at the moment. He's in trouble right now. He casts heal, but will it be enough? As he's getting caught by Flame Road. 2% HP left as he casts Divine Vata. Barely saved there. As the burn damage then could not quite take him as well because he has Divine Vata. The Holy Relic, yes, catching Ray there. Ray is down to 26% HP. As the mana is also down to 37% HP. But will it be enough for Frog here? He has 2% HP left. He needs to cast heal very soon. Does he have heal even up? No, he doesn't have heal up at the moment. He's running away. He's getting caught by the Frostwind as Ray grabs this round once again. Ray wins against Frog once again, the Crusader. As he took huge damage there. Once again, Stance of Faith on the Ice Sphere. So I guess when Stance of Faith is off cooldown, Ice Sphere is off cooldown as well. So this is something I think all Guardians or Crusaders need to bear in mind when they're fighting against Elestra. It's not quite a good skill to use against Elestra because they know that that's a counter once again. So now we have Elestra up against Elestra matchup. Ashes 92 up against Ray here. But Ray is down to 36% HP. She baits the Freezing Sword EX well here. But Ashes here did well to avoid the Frostwind here into a Shockwave. The Fireball hits for 1.6k damage. I think that's level 1 Fireball here for Ashes 92. Right now Ray is getting caught. But double Glacier Wave from both players as they're both frozen here. Quite amusing sight once again. As Ashes Chilling Mist didn't quite manage to connect, she avoids the Shatter though. Both Ice Spear once again, it seems like these two players are casting the same thing at the same time. But look at that, Ray is down to 14% HP as Ashes is in a good position. She gets frozen by Lucky Ice Spear last moments there as Ashes grabs the round for TGIF. I believe they are both down to the last member here, if I'm not wrong. So we have Ashes 92 going up against the last member, which I believe is going to be Jaymarion, the Guardian. Indeed, Jaymarion 18 is out right now. As once again I said, Guardians is quite a good matchup to fight any other classes, but they cannot get caught by the early Frostwind. He avoids, oh, we get hit by the Freezing Sword at the start. Big attack used well this time to avoid, but he gets caught by a Glacial Wave on a Shield Charge here. But he breaks out very fast with his AD spamming. But I think Ashes did well to actually avoid the Electric Smite here. Firewall on Electric Smite as well. I mean, avoids the JC previously. Nice chasing by Ashes there on the Freezing Sword, but the block is out. You can see that Jaymarion is still very healthy here, but got caught by the Ice Spear and the Chilling Mist combo here. But the Chilling Mist didn't quite manage to connect. No idea what happened there, as the Shatter is avoided as well. As right now, Ashes is down to 36% HP. The Glacial Wave avoided with a nice aerial evasion timing from Jaymarion here. As you can see, the Holy Bolt screaming past Ashes. Jaymarion has healed back up to about 74% HP. So right now, Ashes is in a bad position. He's out of mana here. Just to crash avoided once again, but Electric Smite iframe used pretty well here, but look at that, Ashes avoiding Electric Smite as well. But she has no more mana here, she's in trouble definitely, as they're both down to the last man. She jumps to avoid the Holy Bolt, she got caught by the Lightning Zap because she has no mana to blink here. 1% mana here, she used a reactive blink. She got caught by a Shield Charge here, I think it's too little too late for Ashes here, as Jaymarion is going to have an easy time with a mana-less Lestra here. Divine Vata is used, it's going to be overkill definitely, I don't think Jaymarion knows that she's out of mana, but he still chases. He gets his Circuit Hebringen buff up, nice Shinbreaker. Electric Smite avoided here. Just dying moments for Ashes here, he's trying to avoid it. Justice Crash avoided as well, nice Blink, but there's no mana for Oh, the Glacier Wave there cast as well. Look at that, he's moving, he's struggling there left and right, but she has no more mana to avoid the Holy Relic, which is her death. As apparently I'm not right. It's not the last man for TGIF. They still have, I believe, Priest, the Physician. Yeah, we didn't see Priest yet in this matchup here. As right now, Priest, the captain for TGIF, fighting for TGIF for a possible game 3 here, as Para won the previous one. We see Priest going strong here. She gets caught by a Shinbreaker on her air evasion. Her air evasion is used right now. She's in trouble. The bubble bubble avoided with the statue there. So well placement by Jim Arian. The way of attack is used by Priest as well. We see the Magma Wave into Mixed Infection here, but the block is up here. As right now, Jim Arian in a very good position. Even the Justice Crash as well, as you can see. Oh, the Electric Smite as well on Priest. Priest is down to 51% HP. Not looking good for her at the moment here. We see the Ice Palm used defensively, the Wax as well. But once again, if Jim Arian has the Divine Vata up, oh, look at that. The Velofirus hitting Jim Arian as well. So Priest in a very good time right now, but the Bubble Bubble not getting a target, as Divine Vata will be up very, very soon here. As you can see, Jim Arian buying time. As he can slowly trickle the HP of Priest down, he's gonna wait for Lightning Zap, but look at that. Mixed Infection into Magma Wave, very well done. Into Ice Shower on Jim Arian here, but the Divine Vata prevents him from actually taking huge damage. As you can see, Priest healing up, but that's 2000 on the heal once again. She's back to 45% HP as she avoids the Lightning Zap as well. She's trying to buy more time here, but it will be enough here. The airdrop is baited. The Tumble is baited as well. As you can see, Jim Arian going there with Nation Breaker here. The Justice Crash hits as well. The Electric Smite! Oh, it takes Priest away as Jim Arian gets the 2 winning streak and wins the game for Pero. So once again, I hope you guys enjoyed this match between Pero, Perokian, Nijab, and thank god it's Friday, which is TGIF. So remember to check out the other videos from Greenwood if you haven't, and then I'll be uploading the next video, which will be Matt JPL or Matt Siapalang, as I believe a lot of people will be looking forward to Matt matches, who they are actually going up against. Let me check here. They are going up against PH Saga, which I believe is also a very good guild or team as well. So once again, look forward to that. Thanks for watching once again. It's around 6:15 AM right now. I hope my commentary is still as exciting here. So yeah, remember to subscribe, and yeah, I'll see you guys next time.